Nowadays, when it comes to the music industry, it's easier to gain fame and go viral from a catchy song. A lot of new artists are able to propel into the limelight to the point their stardom becomes so rushed, it doesn't leave room for development. Fame becomes so easy, artists aren't generating a reliable, loyal fan base, and in turn aren't able to keep their relevance in the music industry. Artist development is a process any musician goes through to develop their craft and skills necessary to build a professional career in the music industry. This includes everything from voice, songwriting, image and branding, music and video production, live performances, marketing, and even social media presence. In the early 2000s, a lot of artists had to work for their spot. You were literally competing just to be noticed, not just from labels, but from fans. Artists would spend 6 to 8 hours a day alone vocal training and dancing to perfect their craft, which of course did not come easy. The entire process looks good during live performances, but behind the scenes, it takes a lot of practice and physical and mental energy to bring their shows to life and give their fans a great performance. The main point of being an artist was not just to deliver vocally, but to deliver a great performance to keep your fans devoted. Even if you're not a dancer, your vocal ability was enough to captivate an audience. Mariah Carey is one of the best-selling artists in the world and has been touring since the 90s. She relies on background dancers to make her live performances more exciting. And even when she sings an upbeat song, she simply sways to the beat glamorously. Mariah has the privilege of doing so because she has such a beautifully broad vocal range. It wasn't as easy back then as it is now because you either had to have both or one or the other, basically needing to prove yourself before labels backed you. In 2019, Summer Walker released her successful debut album, Over It. And while her album received praise, her tour received a lot of backlash. During this time, Summer was giving lackluster performances and blaming it on her social anxiety. The issue was, Summer has revealed before that she was a stripper, so some people found her social anxiety excuse completely unprofessional. Her lack of energy, stage presence, and late arrivals was really rubbing fans the wrong way. Luckily, Summer is taking the Mariah route and improved her stage presence drastically since her debut album's tour. Saweetie is a rapper who got success and fame from her catchy, upbeat freestyle track, Icy Girl, released in 2018, which is a song that launched her into mainstream stardom. She's been featured in countless songs with mainstream artists like Doja Cat and Jhené Aiko. She has fame and popularity, but when it comes to live performances, her stage presence has been heavily criticized due to her lack of breath control and unpreparedness. Compare that to the acts like Beyonce, Janet Jackson, Usher, and Chris Brown, who have the best of both worlds when it comes to performing, you really see how the bar is very low when it comes to the new music artists in the industry. Beyonce, one of the greatest acts of our time, although she has been performing for years, even pulls herself together to ensure her fans get the best of her. Beychella has to be one of Beyonce's best performances, not because of the performance itself, which was phenomenal, of course, but more so because of the work she put in to achieve it. Beyonce was originally supposed to do Beychella in 2017, but because she has given birth, she had to take a break coming back to perform in 2018. And boy, did she come back. In order to achieve Beychella, Beyonce went on a highly restrictive diet, cutting out bread, carbs, sugar, dairy, meat, fish, and alcohol, working tirelessly 16 to 18 hour days. Although she reused choreography from her previous tour, she implemented an entire theme paying homage to the HBCU experience. She added a twist to the Coachella stage that will forever reign as the best Coachella experiences. Marching bands, majorette dancers, and step, the performance brings light to Beyoncé as an entertainer and the amount of work she did to bring Beychella to life. Because of social media platforms like TikTok, it has been relatively easier to get into the music industry. If your song goes viral, you instantaneously become the next big thing. So much that big-time artists are going to want to hop on your song to catch the new wave. The problem with this is that artists aren't able to maintain their relevance. Although there has been a few that maintain their claim to fame, there's more that faded into obscurity. All because they weren't able to keep their music flow, they got too comfortable, or weren't able to deliver quality albums or soundtracks to their newfound fans. When an artist takes the time to release quality music, it is greatly appreciated by their fan base, so much so that it makes their behavior excusable. R. Kelly is one of the greatest R&B male vocalists of the 90s and early 2000s, and despite his actions, will always be remembered for the countless hits he released. Even so, he was arrested for his advances towards a minor in the infamous 2002 video. He didn't get tried until 2008 and was acquitted of all charges. During 2002, when he was first exposed for his actions, until 2008, when he was tried, he managed to release 5 platinum-selling albums, including a joint project with Jay-Z. Yeah, this man was literally on trial for inappropriate conduct with a minor who was 14 years old. And he still managed to sell platinum-selling albums. 5 of them. 5. His actions will forever be marked in history, but that did not stop his fans from supporting him. Even when he was finally charged and pleaded guilty, in 2022, after R. Kelly pleaded guilty, his streams have risen more than 500% in the week following his conviction. Because R. Kelly has built such a cult following since his debut in the 90s, he will forever have fans that in their minds separate the music from the artist. DaBaby is a rapper that blew up in March of 2019. His debut album peaked at number 7 on the Billboard 200. His second studio album, Blame It On Baby, released 2020, peaked at the number 1 spot, scoring him a number 1 song with Rockstar. DaBaby accumulated a lot of success since his debut, but his recent actions in 2021 leading to 2022 has a lot of people side-eyeing him as a person. His rise to fame and getting away with murder inflamed his ego. And yes, I said murder. In 2018, DaBaby was arrested after fatal murder of a teenager inside a North Carolina Walmart. DaBaby has since said he was acting in self-defense and was acquitted of all charges, making him a free man. Being dissolved of all charges, then releasing a number 1 charting album, definitely made DaBaby feel like he was untouchable. He has acted out on numerous occasions in the media, to the point it painted DaBaby as a bad person. Now, let's go down the long list. He punched a female fan in the face during one of his concerts. He called the cops and kicked out his baby mother, Dani Leigh, and their newborn at 3 a.m. He brought out Tory Lanez during a Rolling Loud concert after Megan just performed. And mind you, this was during the time that Megan pressed charges against Tory Lanez for assaulting her. And the cherry on top was his LGBT comments that were made at Rolling Loud. After this, his reputation went into shambles. He lost endorsements and his shows started getting canceled left and right. He did issue an apology, but it didn't save much face. In 2022, the nail in the coffin was DaBaby releasing a song in which he insinuated that he and former friend Megan Thee Stallion were intimately involved with each other. He did this to bring buzz to his album Baby on Baby 2, and to his dismay, it did the complete opposite. His first week sales were projected at 20K, which is his lowest selling album to date. DaBaby has been mainstream for less than 5 years. He hasn't fully solidified himself and his actions have not been the most appealing to his fan base. Hence his easy decline in the industry and inability to sell albums and tickets now. Despite all odds against an artist, a loyal fanbase will forever keep their name alive. In the midst of erasure or public scrutiny, an artist will never be alone in their battles with their fans in support of them. Janet Jackson is one of the most influential people of all time, not just from being a part of the most notorious musical family in history, but from her contributions she made throughout her music career.
And I would go in there and just watch my brothers rehearse all the time. Everything I could, I tried to be in the middle of with my brothers, and they always had fun, and I loved being around them.
Janet has sold over 100 million records worldwide, attaining 10 number one singles, 5 Grammys, 10 MTV Music Video Awards, and the list goes on. Her albums have been so impactful that her legacy will forever reign next to her brother Michael. Unfortunately, one mistake in her career almost erased her entire legacy. In 2004, Janet Jackson performed at the Super Bowl alongside Justin Timberlake. As part of her performance, he was to rip the bra piece of her bustier top, exposing the red lace piece underneath. Unfortunately, the stunt did not go as planned, as it ended up exposing her whole nipple for thousands to see. This entire performance is what led to Janet's almost diminishing career. Les Moves was the CBS chairman and CEO. All the backlash received from the Super Bowl performance infuriated him, leaving him on a mission to destroy Janet. Moves even went as far as ordering Viacom properties, VH1 and MTV, and all Viacom-owned radio stations to stop playing Janet's songs and music videos, which consequently affected the sales of her Demita Joe album, which was released just a month after the Super Bowl. She went on countless apology tours, but it wasn't enough, and her career never fully recovered to what it used to be, but only with the newer generation. Janet's albums broke constant barriers in the music industry. Her intricate sounds and unique performances ingrained her role as an R&B and pop star, but also as an inspiration to future musicians that will soon follow in her footsteps. Les Moves tried to erase her, but her legacy is beyond what he can undo. She basically birthed and inspired the most iconic females and males in pop and R&B that came after her. When your fan base becomes the next musicians, it shows the work and dedication that you put into your art that will never be forgotten. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I just want to say one more thing to wrap this up. Although it has become easier to become famous in the industry, growing a legitimate fan base has become a lost art. Fan bases are what keeps an artist relevant, historical, and will forever revive your career. You want people to remember the imprint you left in the industry, and they truly are the only key. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you like and subscribe.